So today I'll be assembling this 8 foot by 10 foot Yardmaster metal shed. It comes in two boxes, direct from the manufacturer. Both of those are pretty heavy, particularly the small one. You're probably looking at between 50 and 70 kilos for that smaller one, and not much less for the large one. So first up, I'm going to be having a quick measure up so that I can determine the size of the base I need to assemble for it. And that'll be the first part of the video. This shed will be sitting on basically a mud platform over there. The garden we're working in today is a bit of a tip. That's part of the reason for getting the shed together. Knocking one of these other buildings down inside the garden. So first up, we're going to measure up for the base dimension. And just a quick preview to the unboxing here. This is what you're presented with as soon as you get the boxes open. Just bits of framework here and supports. There's more of it underneath the cardboard inner boxes here. And the instructions inside a bag full of screws, washers. If you think you're going to get this done in a couple of hours, you might want to think again. Okay, so I've got the base rail set out here. I'm kind of learning as I go with this, but essentially you have to follow these instructions, which are not exactly clear. This is for the 10 by 8 shed, so I'm going to use the numbers when I quote part numbers here. All of the part numbers are on the pieces on small stickers, and basically we have to overlap a couple of the railings to create one long rail on the back row here. Same again on the sides. The instructions tell you to overlap these joins. In this case, this is the back rail for the base rail. It's 401.2 here that we're looking at on the left, and then it's 401.14 on my right. Now, it tells you to overlap these pieces by 230 mil. So the way I've measured it is from the most pronounced point on the front edge here to the most pronounced point on the front edge on here, which is basically the frontmost points of each of those panels. You screw them up from underneath. I've only got 5 screws in there at the moment. It's capable of taking 6 screws altogether. So to make things a little bit simpler, and I would recommend you just work from the amount of holes that you have to overlap. So on the leading edge of each panel, you need to overlap by 1, 2, 3, 4 screws, and on the trailing edge you need to overlap by just the 2 screw holes, and that's the joint as you're left with. So 401.14 overlaps 401.2, and on each of the corners, as you build this up, the inner edge of the corner basically has to look like that, so it's stepped together, and then when you come to join the corners with the corner brackets, they'll fit snugly like this. This is the side rail we're back onto now, and again 230 mil is the quoted overlap, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4 screws on the leading edge and 1, 2 screws on the trailing edge. Again, screwed from underneath, and ensure that you've got the corners stepped down inwards, almost a mitered corner if you like, to the next corner. This is the front rail here with the step through plate, just 2 screws holding that together, and as you can see, each of the corners basically has to align with a mitre joint to meet up with the next corner. I have found that this corner, the screw holes are small on both the upper and the lower joint. I'm not too worried about that. I think half of these panels will be manufactured in mass production, of course, so the holes might not always marry up exactly as they should do in terms of sizes, but they should all marry up in terms of their distance between each other. So when you put the screws together, if you're using the bag that's got the longer screws in, it should be labelled as number 1 and labelled as bag number 12 is the plastic weather seals, and you just basically pass the screw through that first from the underside. Bear in mind, some of these holes might not be fully punched through from the factory. You can usually just poke them through with a screwdriver or just drill them a little bit. That's the base rail more or less complete, and on each of the corners I'm going to be fitting this plate here. So once those mitered corners are together, this plate can go on and the screw can go through the top and the sides again with the weather seal on, and that should be the base rail complete, and you'll be able to move on to the next page. Right, so as I'm going for a timber base for my Yardmaster shed, I've gone ahead and assembled that. I've made it a bit bigger than the recommendations in the instruction manual. This is the 10x8 model, and the instructions tell us to make the base 3000 millimeters, so 3 meters wide by 2380 width. Mine's actually about 3 meters by 2.4. So slightly, ever so slightly over by 20 millimeters larger than it needs to be. I just did it that way for convenience with the size of the timbers and the sheets. I've used 3 meter timbers. These are supplied by Wickes, and they're 75 mil by 47 mil, which equates to about 3 inch by 2 inch timbers for the rails. I've put a couple of extra noggins there across the front and across the rearmost runs, just because I had some timber left over, and it supports the frontmost and rearmost walls of the metal shed. I've used OSB board, which is 2.44, so 2440mm by 1220mm. I've used 2.5 of those to go across, and I'll lay out the base rails in a moment so you can get an idea as to how the shed will take up that space that I've provided for it. So that's going to go down onto some shingle, I expect, just to assist in drainage. I've treated all the timbers as I've gone with deck sealer, and I'll do the same for the plyboard, the OSB sheet, and that should just protect it from the weather for a while. I'll lay this down now and lay the framework out for the shed to give you an idea of the use of space. And here is the base rails set out on the base. Now, as you can see, we've got, I don't know, about 4 inches or so either side around the edges. It's just generally quite a decent fit, I think. Some of these exposed edges will be partly protected by the eaves of the roof from the Yardmaster shed. Other than that, you do need a little bit of extra just for sturdiness and to make sure it doesn't shimmy off the edge. Now, the external measurements for the base rails themselves, once they're assembled, is width-wise is 2,830mm, which is approximately 9 foot, 3.5 inches this way. And the width, or the depth if you like, is 2,240mm, which comes out about 7 foot 4. So you're actually looking at a 9 foot 3 inch shed by 7 foot 4 inches. That's the external measurements. This being the 10x8 shed, part numbers are as follows, which is at the back right here I've got 401.14, and that overlaps by 230mm or by 1, 2, 3, 4 screws on the back edge. That overlaps 401.2. That completes your rearmost base rail. For your right hand base rail, 401.2 goes to the far right corner, and that overlaps by 1, 2, 3, 4 screw holes, or 230 mil. That overlaps part number 401.01 for the near right corner. Over to the left hand side, the longest rail for the far left side is 401.2. That overlaps by 1, 2, 3, 4 screw holes again. That overlaps part number, which has disappeared, but it will be 401.01 again. And that's for the near left front edge. Now, the frontmost beam consists of just three pieces. There's a 408, 409.3, I think that is. Basically, these two are identical, and they connect together with two screw holes to the threshold bar, which is 608.3. And that goes with the longest leading edge goes facing into the shed, leaving the shorter ramp at the front. There are your base rails assembled, and they'll just need to go together with the corner plates to meet up like this in a mitered edge. And that'll be the next part of the video, building up from the base rails.